Welcome everyone, I'm Ricky here from Tech Talk, and today we're doing a very special video on the OnePlus 7 Pro. Today we're going to be taking a look at the accessibility features and functions that you're going to find on this brand new device from OnePlus, which are really impressive actually. I'm looking forward to going through with it. So first of all, accessibility settings are there at the beginning when you first set up your device, which is really nice. Thanks to Android 9, which is Android Pie, it does give you some accessibility settings from when you first get your device when you're going through the setup process, which I showed on my unboxing. But having them settings there right at the beginning helps you set up your device the best way that you want to, which I think is really key. There's also another option by using the volume controls down the left-hand side. Press both of these together.
Talk back on. OnePlus launcher.
Talkback is there via the volume key shortcut, which is really good. So Talkback is a great feature that's going to talk through everything you touch and highlight on your device. So if we start down here.
Phone, messages, Chrome, camera, gallery, Play Store, actions, shortcuts and notifications, remove move item, double tap to activate, double tap and hold to long press.
So it tells you everything once you've actually stopped highlighting different things. It's a really good feature to have if you are visually impaired or if you have really low vision. You can read through everything on your device. And I think this is a really good feature. Having loads of RAM and good power and performance in this device as well is helping it flow so quickly. I've used this off screen and it's been an enjoyment to use. So I can touch and highlight different things up here at the top.
Battery 94%, Wi-Fi signal full, Twitter notification, Andy voice, Instagram notification, Hi Jantech, Hygen_tech, started following you, 11:45 a.m.
So it'll read everything to me, which is a really good thing. So to navigate, use two fingers.
Apps list, hidden space.
So you can slide up and down using two fingers. You'll hear that pitch tone, meaning you're going up and down. And once I stop, it'll tell me where I am. And then I can go through.
Calculator, calendar, camera, Chrome, community.
Double tap.
Home screen,
to go home.
One of two.
So Talkback is a great feature here built into the device, built in via a shortcut as well. When you first turn on that shortcut, it will ask you to go through a tutorial. And I really recommend you do that to learn all the functions about moving, the double taps, long presses, that you need to use Talkback. So to turn this off, press and hold the volume keys together.
Talkback off.
And then Talkback will turn off. So that's always preset into the volume controls on Android 9 and other versions, which is really good to see. And I really like that that option is there to use even before you go into the settings. So let's go into the settings. You're gonna swipe up. You're gonna go down to the bottom here. You're gonna go to settings. You could also search for this as well if you want to. If you search for accessibility settings, it will take you there. You need to then go to system. So it is a little bit buried. I'm a little bit worried here, and I will let them know that it's buried quite deep down in the system options. Then finally at the top, you've got accessibility option. And inside here, you can see a long menu of different options that we're going to go through now. So the first one at the top is a volume key shortcut. So this is the one I've talked about already, and you can change which one you want to use, which is good as well. So you can change from all these different options. So if you press and hold the volume key, you can change to choose which one you want it to use. I set it to Talkback, as that's the main one that I want to use and I've used previously. Underneath that is your accessibility menu. So going inside here, we can toggle this on and we're going to hit OK. Once toggled on, you're going to see a little accessibility man down here at the bottom, and it gives you loads of options to choose from, which is really good as well. There's more on another page. Tapping that little accessibility man will dismiss this. Go into settings here, and you've got some settings that you can change and adjust as well. Underneath that, you've got select to speak. So this is slightly different compared to Talkback, and I'm going to actually let it explain why it's slightly different. So turn on, you're going to hit OK. Again, you're going to see an accessibility man down here, and then you're going to press play.
Navigate up, select to speak, use service, on, settings. When select to speak is on, you can tap specific items on your screen to hear them read aloud. First, tap the icon. Then you can tap a specific item, like text or an image. Drag your finger across the screen to select multiple items. Tap the play button to hear everything on screen. Select text that appears inside the camera view.
So it will only read things that you have selected to speak. So if I tap here and then tap here.
When select to speak is on, you can
it reads
tap
that
specific
text body.
Items on your
screen. It didn't read it right from the beginning. So that's a really good option to have here. I'm really pleased to see that's on here as well as Talkback. You then have switch access. So switch access gives you the ability to use switches and interaction controls with your phone to help you manipulate your way around your phone if you can't with your hands or your fingers. A really important setting to have, and it seems like it's becoming more and more on devices now, and I'm really happy to see that. These devices are helping anyone with any type of ability. Then you have talkback. So I've already gone through talkback, and it's that description of everything on your display. So we're not going to bother going through this. There is a settings option here that you can change and adjust your settings. And they, as you can see, there's quite a wide range of settings in here that you can change and adjust. So it's not just the actual option, but more times you will have settings as well. Then you have text to speech outputs. This is where you can change your speech rate and your pitch. So we can make it really fast.
This is an example of speech synthesis in English.
And then you can make it really high.
This is an example of speech synthesis in English.
So you can then reset as well. Again, a good option because some people that use it all the time can go through it really quickly and don't need it to be so slow. Then you have font size. So we can go in here and change the font size. So as you can see, it's on the largest font already, which is slightly worrying. I wish it could go a little bit bigger, but having it a white text on black background helps. And we'll go through that a little bit later, how to change that. Then you have display size. So I can pump this up a little bit. And you have some presets here, just showing you what it looks like. And then now we've done that, it's gonna make this a little bit bigger as well for me. Underneath that you have magnification. So we're gonna turn this on inside here. One, two, three quick taps and you're gonna jump in. You can pinch to zoom as well. And with an AMOLED panel here, it's gonna work really fast and look really good as well. With a 90 hertz refresh rate as well, you're gonna really fly around here and move up really quickly. One, two, three, come back. There is another option as well where you hold on your third tap. So one, two, three. With one finger, now I can manipulate and move around wherever I want to. But as soon as I release, it will go back to normal. Underneath that, you have color correction. So color correction can help people that have issues with their eyesight. And these are the different options that it helps you with. Then you have color inversion. So if I toggle this on here, color inversion will invert the colors for you. But when you go home, the colors have really changed as well. So a little bit different to a dark theme, which I'll show you a bit later on. Then have the ability to use a large mouse pointer if you want to manipulate your way around your device and maneuver around different settings and different options. You then have animation. So once animation is on, you'll just get no flashiness of it. It just switches on and off without the actual animation effect. So it will switch on and off without the flashy animation effect there. So dwell timing automatically allows you to make an action come true, say your mouse pointer stops moving. This is kind of a new feature that we're seeing on accessibility menus now, and I'm really pleased to see that on here as well. So you can use your power button to end calls if you so wish to. So the power button is here on the right hand side, and there's a textual difference between the slider that offers you ring, vibrate and silence. Then you have auto rotate screen. So when you're in certain applications, you'll be able to rotate your device and it will rotate for you. Obviously it's not going to work in the menus here. It does on some other devices, so it'd be nice to see that come over to this one as well. You then have touch and hold delay. So if you need a delay when you're touching, or if you've got a bit of shake or dexterity or interaction issues, this might be the option for you to choose. Then you have vibration as well. So you have touch vibration and ring and notification vibration options inside here that you can turn on or off. You have the ability to use mono audio. After that is captions. So inside captions here, you can change and adjust the different options that you need to use captions. So if I toggle this on and then go into text size, we can change text size. Language, we can change language. And then appearance, we can have different appearances here as well. So that's really good and really helpful to have on a device if you need captions. So then after that, you have hearing aid compatibility. Again, this is quite a new setting and we're seeing it more and more on devices, and I'm really pleased to see it on here as well. Then finally at the bottom, you have high contrast text. So if I toggle this off, the actual headings go to blue. But otherwise, if I keep it on, it stays white and a little bit easier for me to read. That's all the options we find in the accessibility menu. There are some other options I do want to show you though. So if we go into display, so come back again, and then go up to the top, and then we're gonna go into display here. So in display here, we've got a couple of other options. First of all, you've got your brightness that you can change and adjust depending on your choice, which is really helpful. Your sleep, I've changed mine to the longest time possible, which is like 30 minutes. So my screen won't go to sleep. Then you have night mode as well. So once toggled on, if I toggle night mode on, you can see that yellow tinge in the text now. That means it's lowering that harsh blue light for you, and you can actually enjoy reading at nighttime without actually damaging your eyesight, which is really good. You can schedule it, and then you've got color temperature and lightness as well. Underneath that, you then have reading mode. So in reading mode here, it gives you the experience of reading an ebook and actually enjoy reading data and text off your device. If I toggle this on here, the colors will go gray. And if I go home here, you can see it's a gray style and a little bit easier to read text. So if you want to enjoy content, maybe not the mode for you. But if you want to read ebooks or read a heavy website or a heavy document that's full of text, this might be the option for you to use. So go back in here. If I toggle this off, it goes back to normal and easier for me to see than to carry on with the video. You then have screen calibration, so you can change and adjust the screen here. You can have vivid, neutral, or advanced. If you go in advanced, you have more options here to use and adjust to change whichever way you want it and however it best suits you and your ability. One big thing with the OnePlus 7 Pro is the refresh rate. So inside here, you can change and adjust the refresh rate. 90 is really quick. So with 90, it means you can fly through the menus really quick. There's no hesitation, lag, or stuttering. It's just a quick, smooth, buttery movement. And it's really nice to have. So you can go in here, you can change and adjust it if you so wish to, but it's actually preset on 90 hertz, which is really good. And I think it's a really good feature to just show off here. Underneath that is resolution. So you can change and adjust the resolution of your display. So it's got auto switch at the moment. If I want it on the best settings here, I'm going to choose the Quad HD Plus, and then it'll be the best, but also this will impact your battery. So please make a note of that, that it will impact your battery. Then the other option that I want to show you in here is theme. So you can have light. So I'll give it a second just to change it. So it's quite bright and quite vibrant. You can have color. So when I go back to menu here, we've got all different color options. Then if we go finally to dark, which I had it on, just makes it so much easier to use and enjoy and read because it darkens everything. So as you can see, it's white text on a black background, making it ever so easy to read. So if I pull down here, my widget area is in black, but my notification area is in white, but it just makes it easier to read. And I think that's a really good thing. So coming back home, really impressed with the amount of settings that are on here. There is room though for improvement as always. And I'm gonna take the slogan here from OnePlus, never settle. Let's always improve and move forward to bring new settings and new options to our devices to help anyone, no matter their ability. With other devices, there are more settings that are more changeable. They go deep into the system options to change the settings. I would like that to come over to the OnePlus, and I believe it will. So let's take the OnePlus slogan there and never settle and really see an improvement in the next device and in the future. Currently, there are so many options on here. It does cover a wide range of different accessibility needs, meaning that people with any ability can use this device, which is really good. And that's the main thing. I hope you have enjoyed this video. And if you have any questions or any queries about the OnePlus 7 and its accessible settings or options, please leave a comment down below and I'll be more than happy to help. If you're new to Tech Talk, please subscribe and ring the notification bell to stay updated with all of my latest videos. From me, Ricky, I will see you very soon. Bye for now.